Good morning, everyone. Good morning. This is Pastor Paul Graham, and I'm the Senior Pastor of Restoration Praise Center and also your host on Bible Boot Camp. We're so glad that we have this opportunity to just spend this time together, this beautiful time together, this awesome time together. 5 o'clock this morning, we are up, we are ready to be a part of this worshipful experience. And this worshipful experience begins with revival. We believe and know that God wants to do something special in our lives. So he's asking us to be revived. We're looking to be revived with him and him alone. So we welcome each one of you to this time, and we say to wake up and stretch your spiritual muscles and be a part of this experience. Now, when you wake up in the morning, you wake up at 5 o'clock, you be a part of this experience, and then you recognize that God is trying to do something in your life. He's trying to do something in our lives. So he's saying to us, be revived. Wake up and be revived. God wants to do something with us today. In light of this, we want you to know that we have been waiting for this whole month, 31 days. It's going to take 31 days. That's right. We are live on Periscope. We are also on PastorPaulGraham.com and also on Praise Vision. And we want you to know that your May is going to start off right. It's going to start off just right. So before we begin, we ask God's blessings. We ask his presence into this place, wherever you are, whatever you are, whatever you're doing. We're pausing right now because we simply want God to know that we are ready. We are actually ready for this time with him. So let's bow our heads together as we look to God, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Let's pray together. Father, again, we come before you thanking you for all that you've done. We thank you for life, and we thank you for strength. We thank you for the opportunity of prayer and praise. And this very morning, we're looking to be revived in you and with you. And so this morning, we ask that whatever is said and done will be pleasing to you. Whatever we say, whatever we do, whatever we concentrate on, Lord, we concentrate on you. So we thank you right now for giving us this opportunity to just wake up and be a part of this experience. So bless us and all those who woke up and all those who are ready. In Jesus' name, amen. And so for those who are on with us now, we are excited about starting this very time together. And so we're talking about being revived. Have you ever been in a place where you have been working and working and working and didn't have the time to rest, didn't have the time to stop, didn't have the time to just say, wait a second, let me give myself a break? Well, that's what being revived is all about. Being revived is all about starting over again and starting over again with an experience with God, with his Holy Spirit, being stronger than you've ever been before. And we believe that you can be strong. We believe that you can be better than you've been. But you want to be revived, not on your own, but with the Holy Spirit. Are we ready to be revived this whole month of May? That's right. The whole month of May, we are looking to be revived in Jesus Christ. And so right now, I want to share with you this very opportunity of being revived in him. Well, somebody has to be tired. Somebody's got to be tired of the same old life, the same old way, the same old stuff. And because you're tired of the same old way and the same old stuff, we're simply saying to you that right now you can pause and be revived. Okay, there's a special song I want to share with you. Oh man, it's an awesome song I want to share with you. It's a song that's called I Understand by Smokey Norfolk. And as we listen to this song, believe and know that God wants us to be revived in him. Let's listen to this together.
Sometimes I feel like giving up. It seems like my best just ain't good enough. Lord, if you hear me, I'm calling you. Do you see, do you care all about what I'm going through? And then he said, one more day. one more step. See, I'm preparing you for myself. And when you can't hear my voice, please trust my plan. I'm the Lord, I see, and yes, I am. Just like a stranger, so far from home. I feel like I've done all that I can do. Please, Lord, give me strength. I'm just trying to make it through. That's when he told me. I am the Lord, and I change it not. I won't forget, nor have I forgot. You see, everything works according to my plan. I am God, trust me, I got the whole world in my hands.
He understands the plan. If you can't see his way, if you don't understand his plan, just wait. Give him some time in your life, because God understands everything that you're going through. And sometimes we can't be revived simply because we feel like we're stuck in a rut in whatever you are stuck in. But God's plan is for you to come out. God's plan is for you to be revived. And if you think he doesn't understand, believe me, Jesus understands. You know, this very month, as we talk a little bit about being revived, this month, as we talk a little bit about the stuff you're going through, or this month, as we talk a little bit about where God wants to place you, we want you to know that God can do anything in your life. One thing I recognize about Bible Boot Camp and this special time is that God wants each one of us. That's right. He wants you and myself to develop a plan and to develop a regimen that's going to keep us strong with him, that's going to keep us revived in him. And God wants us to develop this kind of plan. But I need you to know that God has instilled in each one of us the Holy Spirit that will help us to be strong at all points and all times. I'm going to give you an example. Last July, I took the time out to really start doing something special in my life. And I began to make my bed every single day. So since the month of July, I've been making my bed every single day. And as I'm making my bed every single day, I'm realizing and I'm recognizing that it's becoming a habit and a regimen for me. that if I can make my bed every single day, I can spend time in God's Word at least 2 to 3 minutes a day, which may not be a long time, but it is some time. And so I began making my bed every day. And I've done it so far every day, every single day, especially when I'm home. I do it every single day. If I'm away, I just probably make it up or make up a hotel bed or something of that nature. But I've been making my bed every day. And it gives me the opportunity to remember that if I can do that every day and develop that habit every day, then I can develop great habits. And then I want you to hear of something. I heard this speech given by I believe it was an army colonel. And when I heard this speech, I said, wow, that's the reason why we need to be making our beds or praying every day or seeing every day or having devotion every day, because God wants us to develop great habits. And in these next 31 days, we're going to be developing habits. We're going to be developing great habits. I want you to listen to this as we look not just to make our bed, but to spend our time with God.
Every morning in SEAL training, my instructors, who at the time were all Vietnam veterans, would show up in my barracks room, and the first thing they'd do was inspect my bed. If you did it right, the corners would be square, the covers would be pulled tight, the pillow centered just under the headboard, and the extra blanket folded neatly at the foot of the rack. It was a simple task, mundane at best, but every morning we were required to make our bed to perfection. It seemed a little ridiculous at the time, particularly in light of the fact that we were aspiring to be real warriors, tough, battle-hardened SEALs. But the wisdom of this simple act has been proven to me many times over. If you make your bed every morning, you will have accomplished the first task of the day. It will give you a small sense of pride, and it will encourage you to do another task, and another, and another. And by the end of the day, that one task completed will have turned into many tasks completed. Making your bed will also reinforce the fact that the little things in life matter. If you can't do the little things right, you'll never be able to do the big things right. And if by chance you have a miserable day, you will come home to a bed that is made, that you made. And a made bed gives you encouragement that tomorrow will be better. So if you want to change the world, start off by making your bed.
Wow, isn't that amazing? If you want to change the world, hey, let's start off by making your bed. If you really want to change your life, you got to start somewhere. If you want things to change in your life, you've got to start somewhere. I mean, if you really want to be on fire for God, you've got to start somewhere. If you want to be on fire for the things that you're waiting to do in your life, or the things that you want to accomplish in your life, you've got to start somewhere. And I want you to know that God wants you to start off somewhere, and he wants you to start now. Listen, if you want to reinforce the fact that you can be greater, if you want to know that you want to be great at bigger things, and the little things does matter. It says, and if you have, by chance, have a miserable day, remember how you started your day out. You started your day out in Bible boot camp, or you started your day out in worship, or you started your day out in devotion, because God wants each one of us to be devoted to him, to develop these habits, to be revived. And I want you to know that God wants be on fire for him. He wants you to be on fire for him. And you can, because revival begins with you. Oh man, I want you to just I want to share a text with you. I want to share a text with you before we even move forward. And I want you to know that God wants us to not just be revived, right? But he wants us to stay revived. He wants us to stay revived in him. So all those who are on our Periscope channel, all those who are online with us at PastorPaulGraham.com, I want to share something with you. That God is able to do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. I'm going to ask you to share with us, for all those who are online, whether you're on Praise Vision or whether you're on one of our chat rooms, that I want you to just write down, What habit do you want God to help you with? What habit do you want God to help you with? So if you can do something every day to make you better, what would it be? Like mine was making my bed. And in making my bed, I believe that God has helped me with the other habits. What do you want to do better? Do you want to pray more often? Do you want to study more often? Do you want to read your Bible more often? What is it that you want to do? So all those who are on Periscope, all those who are with us at this time, wherever you are, just jot it down right now. May 1st, the first day, what do you want to start doing that God's going to take you to the next level with in being revived? We have someone on Periscope who simply says, you know, I want to read more. All right, I got one. And then someone says, I want to finish what I started. I mean, I think that's a beautiful beginning. For those who are with us, just keep on writing, because we believe that when you put it out there to others who are even praying for you, right, then you will have more of that oomph to get ready to go. Someone says, stop cussing and reading their Bible more. Man, I hear you and I understand. Someone says reading their Bible, reading their Bibles and their Sabbath school lesson even more. That's beautiful. And I'm telling you right now, God can take any habit. Watch this. He can take any habit that you have and turn it all around. He can turn it around for you. Now, imagine you're saying you want to read more. You can, but it has to start with day one. Somebody said they wanted to read their Sabbath school lesson more, their Bible more. It starts with day one. Someone said they want to begin speaking life. Come on now, instead of speaking curses. And it starts today. Come on now, with day one. Because day one, today, day one is fire starting right now. It's that match starting right now. It's that beginning starting right now. And you can do it right now in and through Jesus Christ. We have others who simply said that they want to read their word more consistently. I see that, Adam and Lenise, being more consistent with just being consistent. That's awesome. And Vivian, I see what you're saying. I want to be consistent in, you want to be consistent in your spiritual walk. And that's what we want to do. And that's why today, that's why this very moment, we're talking about being revived. And I believe, and we believe, that we can be revived. I believe that if we take this time out as we are being Bible boot camp strong individuals, we believe that God can do anything for us. Someone even says not just reading the word, but they want to be individuals who understand the word. And so right now, as we are fire-based, come on now, hot-based, we're starting off hot this morning, 5 o'clock this morning, we look to this word. Let's bow our heads together. And as we bow our heads together, let's look at what God is telling us in this word. Let's pray. Father God, we come before you simply asking you to bless us this very day. Now, right now, as we just get a gem from your word, we want you to know that we expect to be revived and to be revived in you. We believe there's nobody else but you. We believe that there's no one stronger but you. We believe that no one can put us on fire but you. And so this morning, we put our hands in your hands, in Jesus' name, amen. And so this morning, right, this morning, we want you to look at this text. This text takes us to an important, important part of our lives from Psalms 85, verse 6, which simply says, will you revive us again, that your people may rejoice in you? That's what David is asking. David is saying, will you not revive us again, that your people may rejoice in you? Wow, that text right there is simply saying, Lord, will you revive us again? Which means that we can't revive ourselves. Time after time again, we feel like we can revive ourselves, and that's where we mess up. We mess up when we think that we can do it on our own, and we cannot do it on our own. We need God in our lives. We need the Holy Spirit in our lives. So what then is revival? Revival is actually each one of us being vived again. Yes, some of you are saying, okay, what does that word vived mean? But when we look at that word vived, vived means to live. And to live or relive or live again is us saying we can start all over again, but even better than we were before. Hey, the psalmist is asking God for revival so that once again the people of God can rejoice. That means somebody's not rejoicing. Someone's not excited. Someone is not into God. Someone is not happy. Someone is not revived. Someone is not living the way they need to live. And we're not living the way we need to live. We're not living that life because. And where are we stuck? But hey, maybe we're stuck in a situation. Maybe we're stuck in sadness. Maybe we're stuck in a place where we just feel like God can't do for us. But when we're revived, we know that we are made alive again in Christ. And you can't be made alive in a situation that makes us feel good just this one time. Too many times when we're feeling down, right? Or when we're feeling like we can't get up, or we feel like we're depressed, or we feel like we're down and out, we become revived just for a small moment. And that small moment that we're revived in earthly things. And maybe it's a movie, maybe it's food, maybe it's company, or maybe it's individuals that we shouldn't even have in our lives. Maybe it's the environment that we're in that keeps us revived just for a moment. But we're talking about being revived in Jesus Christ for not just a moment, but something that's going to last in our lives. Listen, if you are not a Christian, right? And you can't even be revived because you have to be revived in someone. And you've got to be revived in Christ. Ephesians 2 verse 5 talks about being revived or starting over or being in Him. If you are a believer, if you draw a circle around where you're standing, revival begins in where it begins. It begins in that circle. Revival begins not just with you, right? It doesn't just begin with you, but it begins in someone, which is Jesus Christ. You know, when I look at this text again, right? When I look at what the word is saying, it's also saying that the Hebrew word for revive means chaya. That's right. It means to be quickened. That's right. It means to be made alive. And it means to be restored. Wow. So let's look at these three aspects. It means to be quickened, right? It means to be made alive. It means to be restored. Wow. So can you be revived in Christ? Can you be restored? Can you be quickened? The answer is yes. You can be quickened. You can be restored. You can be made alive. That word means, it means, the word is chaya, that Hebrew word that means to be quickened, restored. And you can be quickened and restored even now. But you know, the enemy doesn't want you to be restored. The enemy doesn't want you to be restored. He wants you to stay in the place that you're in. He wants you to be stuck in the place that you're in. He wants you to be messed up for some time. And I want you to know that God can take us from where we are to the next step. But I want you to also know that you must be revived, watch this now, by the Spirit. Because it's the Spirit that revives us and takes us into new birth. God wants you to start your life all over again with Him. He wants you to start this day in Him like only He can. Today, day number one, challenge yourself to be revived today through the Holy Spirit. If you can't remember why you have been down and staying down and out, I'm going to tell you why. Because you have not invited the Holy Spirit yet to revive you. And I need you to know that you can be revived. John 3 verse 3 and 7 says He wants to give us new birth. And that new birth is in Him. Somebody say hallelujah this morning for day one. Day one for the rest of your life. Day one begins today for the rest of your life. Today begins that day when God is going to do something in your life. When He's going to do something for you. But you got to do something in Him first. And today you started. Today you woke up. Today you're deciding to be consistent in your walk. Today you're deciding to read more. Today you're deciding not to cuss. Today you decide to speak blessings. Today, one more day, one more step in Jesus Christ. Let's be revived. In this very morning, I'm going to ask you to write out your prayer request right now. Come on, go ahead. Write out your prayer request right now. And as you write out your prayer request, we're going to come back and we're going to pray. Because we believe and know that God can do anything in our lives. And we're praying today that we will be revived in Him. As you write down your prayer request, let's meditate on this. And come back for prayer. So right now we're getting ready for prayer. We see that the prayer requests are coming in right now. And right now we ask that the Holy Spirit would be with us as we look to Him, who's the author and finisher of our faith. We look to Him who can do all things. And so right now we ask you to bow your heads right where you are as we look to God who can do all things for us. I'm talking about all things for us. And so let's pray and let's look to Him. Father, we come before you thanking you for all that you've done. We thank you for life and for strength and the opportunity of prayer and praise. This morning we come to you knowing that there's no one else but you in our lives. We come before you knowing that you are a great God. You've been a great God to us and you're still a great God to us. Lord, we are pausing at this time because we believe and know that you can do all things. And so this very morning, Lord, we look to you, the only one who can revive us. We look at Adam right now, who's praying for consistency in reading and his faith walk. And Lord, he's also developing a movie right now. So I'm asking you right now, you put your hands on him and his staff. I'm asking you right now that you bring Vivia, as we're praying for her daughter, Brianna, and grad school, that she would desire God more. Lord, I'm asking you to be with her and bless her, strengthen her also in this series called Revival. We bring before you Nina at this time as we're asking for you to bless her, that she would be a living witness. She's also working out, Lord, so put her in the right shape for health that she needs to be in. We also ask you to bless her sons. We see Sam at this time, and they're praying for employment and a sense of direction and restoration. We're asking right now, Lord, right now, you be with Denise as she's praying for health and strength and renewal of mind, body, and spirit. And thanking you for your blessings and her family and friends. There's others on Periscope who've reached out, Lord, who's asking for special prayer for one to be closer with God, for Siri to be closer with God, her relationship. One who is asking to help make them mindful of decisions that they need to make in you. Graduating, others who are graduating and still in school. And we're asking you, Lord, that you bless those who are just simply trying to walk with you. And this morning, we're pausing to say we want to be revived. We want to be revived in your Holy Spirit. We want to be revived through your Holy Spirit. We just want to be revived in you. We want to thank you for waking us up this morning and being a part of this worshipful experience, knowing that you can do all things in our lives. So we're saying no longer are we stuck in the rut, but now we're saying we want to be revived in you. So now, Lord, we've reached day one. And day one, we put it in your hands. And we simply say, Lord, we trust you. In Jesus' name, amen. And so now we want to thank you for joining us on our first day of Bible Boot Camp. We want to thank you for being a part of this worshipful experience. It's a worshipful experience. And we know that you can be revived. We're asking you to invite your friends and your relatives to be a part of this. Let someone know that May is beginning. May 1st is right here, right now. And this is the first day of being revived in Jesus Christ. Go to our Facebook page and share with others, because they're going to be able to watch this again. And I also want you to know that God wants us to be challenged. So share this with someone. It simply says, if it doesn't challenge you, it won't change you. We've used this time and time again, but for the first challenge today for you, it simply is, if it doesn't challenge you, it won't change you. That is our thrust for the day, to be challenged in Him. Thank you for joining us on Bible Boot Camp. Be strong and be revived in Him. Be blessed.